Hello. Welcome to another episode of Forgotten Cemetery, Pacific Northwest. Today we're at Bellevue Cemetery, located in Bellevue, Oregon. Alternative names of the cemetery include Yoakum and Yoakum. It's two different spellings for that, and North Bellevue. So let's go meet some local residents and hear their story. All right, a little history about this hidden little cemetery out in the middle of nowhere, and I believe it is abandoned. I try to use that that label lightly, but yeah, this one's kind of like, ooh, it's out there. It's overgrown. I guess we'll see during the tour. But this cemetery was established in 1858, so old one, with 25 to 100 burials per the Oregon Burial Site Guide. To find a grave is shown around 60 memorials, so not much has changed. This cemetery is on the Thomas J. Yoakum donation land claim. He is buried here, and hopefully we'll find his grave. It's going to be a challenge to find people because there is a lot of overgrowth here. But Thomas is an immigrant of 1847. However, the area of Bellevue is on the Hathaway-Yocum donation land claim. So I guess he owned all this apparently at one time, the entire area. Not really sure. But he's not buried here. He's in McMinnville. But he arrived in Oregon in 1850. The Bellevue area was settled in around 1860 from my readings. And Bellevue translates to beautiful view in French, so I believe that is an accurate description. Kind of got a nice view of the Yamhill Valley here. Other than that, a very brief community mentioned in my Oregon history books, and no interesting factoids about weird plants or animals today, sorry. But for such a small cemetery, it's loaded with history. We have 1840s arrivals, Civil War vets, an individual buried here whose grandfather served in the Revolutionary War, and we'll learn the famous all-night horseback ride of a 16-year-old girl that helped warn American forces of the British attack during the Revolutionary War, so that should be cool. I believe there's a Knights of Pythias marker here as well, and we'll see that, which stands for friendship, charity, and benevolence. Here is Jesse Looper Yoakum, born in 1815. I figured we'd start off with the earliest birth year of the Yoakums, which is spelled three different ways in this cemetery. And if you look back in the records, the name spelling changes drastically. It's pretty incredible the work someone put in to track down the family ancestry. If you like go to Find a Grave, you can click through their history and all that fun stuff. But on Find a Grave, it goes back to a Heinrich Yoakum, born in 1621 in Germany. So a family with a pretty deep history. The Yoakums came to Oregon in the famous year of 1847, one day before Halloween, in fact. I'm guessing this headstone is one of the newer ones. The Find a Grave picture was like pristine. This one's a little beat up, so I'm not sure anyone's been here for a while. I get that impression. All right, hidden in the back is the headstone of Thomas and Elizabeth. First, we'll start off with Thomas Jefferson Yoakum, born in 1828, and as mentioned before, came in 1847 to Oregon. It says he first settled in Deer Creek, which is apparently in Yamhill, but as mentioned, the cemetery is on his donation land claim. On to Elizabeth, which I thought I read online that she's on there as well. I can't see anything on the headstone, so maybe you guys can. But Elizabeth Thorpe Yoakum, very early arrival into Oregon, she came in 1845. Most of her family is buried in Deer Creek Cemetery, which is why I'm enjoying cemetery exploration, because I've never come across Deer Creek, and it'll be a future visit, hopefully. I say hopefully because of that evil label located on private property comes up a lot in Oregon, so hopefully that's not one of them. And here is Robert Bishop Griffith, born in Brooklyn, New York in 1846. He served in the 17th Illinois Cavalry Regiment, and when you pull up the Wikipedia profile on this regiment, they have a cool soldier record pick here. I'll try to put in the video. But for some reason, Robert is listed as Thomas E. Griffin. Not sure why. Looks like a big part of the scuffles they were in were with Confederate General Sterling Price during his Missouri expedition. Okay, took a while. This is a challenging cemetery, and you'll see during the tour. I think the tour will be really fun. But here's the headstone of Milton S. Chapman, born in 1836 in Michigan and a Civil War veteran. Says he served in the 30th Indiana Infantry Regiment, and I don't think we've seen Indiana that much, but they were busy. They saw action in the famous Battle of Shiloh, Stones River, Nashville, the Atlanta Campaign, etc. Also read they saw action at the Second Battle of Franklin, which was one of the worst disasters for the Confederate Army, apparently. Mainly because John Bell Hood kept trying frontal assaults against a pretty stout Union defense, and lost quite a bit of men. More importantly, they lost 14 Confederate generals and 55 commanders. I also read the Army of Tennessee retreated with a little over half of the men they started off the battle with, so pretty heavy losses. Believe it or not, We're in the center of the cemetery. It is very overgrown. But somewhere out there is the marker of Roba Jerusha Millard Arthur, long name. Born in 1851 and died at the young age of 55 in 1906. But like I said before, I like to click through family history and see if anything interesting pops up. And I found out that Roba's grandfather served in the Revolutionary War, Private Solomon Millard, who served in the 7th Regiment of the Dutchess County, New York. This regiment was under the command of the famous Henry Ludington. He oversaw a network of spies during the Revolutionary War. In addition, he became an assistant to George Washington by providing him spies. A famous legend I came across was of a Ludington's daughter. The commander received reports that the British landed in the Long Island Sound and were planning to attack Danbury, Connecticut. Commander Ludington was a bit of a predicament because he needed to quickly organize, rally his troops, and couldn't make the ride to the nearby towns to warn them and gather more troops. So the only real option for him was his 16-year-old daughter. With that said, his daughter Sybil Ludington made a famous all-night horseback ride to warn American forces of the imminent attack on Danbury, Connecticut. Apparently it's said that she rode 40 miles by horseback all night. Unfortunately, it would be too late as Danbury would be burned. However, the military was able to organize just in time to prevent entry into New York. There's a statue memorial of her riding a horse in Carmel, New York. It even has her own stamp for all you stamp collectors out there. Our last stop, who was the hardest to find, as you can see why, was Joseph V. Williams, a Spanish-American war veteran who served in Company A of the Oregon Volunteer Infantry. Their engagements include the capture of Guam and Battle of Manila. And if you visit downtown Portland, there's actually a Spanish-American War Soldiers Monument for fallen soldiers during that war. Alrighty, time for the tour, and getting here is a little questionable. So you gotta drive up this big hill here, like at the very end of the road, and there's barbed wire fence, I think on both sides. This is private property over here, so don't mess around. But all the way down there, there's a farmer's road. It looks abandoned, but that's the way you get to the cemetery, believe it or not. I would recommend a big truck like mine. I think a car, you're going to struggle. And that's only because the weeds are like this high and you're just driving over them to get to this location. Which I think is how forest fires are started. Right? The exhaust catches on fire. Not the exhaust. Ignites the plants. Anywho, we have a pretty unique memorial when you pull in. It's quite noticeable with a gate around it. And it's of Mrs. Douglas Payne. Yeah. 52, oh, she's only 20 something when she died. The cemetery is abandoned. Quite abandoned, I'd say. See evidence of vandalism. I don't think anyone's been here a while because all the plants don't look like they're trampled on or driven over. The plots are very much overgrown. Usually you look for the concrete curb a lot of these places. But someone over here, Florence Perrin? Something there. Don't know. As you can see, there's another plot over there. Work our way over there. Gotta take a detour though. Everything's so overgrown and our BFFs, blackberries, are here. Nice view though. Google, they want you to park over there by, like, I think it's a winery or something. Don't park there because I think it's private property. I'll put directions in the show notes. But here's Kirby's plot. I imagine there's probably headstones in there. Well, I don't know about. Hopefully they're documented. Civil War veteran chaplain here. I'll just go down here for the fun of it. through the blackberries. Anything for you guys? Just concrete. Man. I'd say this is the worst I think I've visited so far, as far as neglect. I thought that Whiskey Hill one was like, eh, but someone was like trying to clear a path. This one, maybe the poster child for Forgotten Cemeteries channel. Somebody's hidden in here. Wade. I'm trying to look in there. I don't see anything yet. The tour is fun and depressing at the same time, I guess you could say. Eaton M. Curly Davis. It's a tiny little headstone just hidden on the side of the thing there. Road. I'm trying to take it slow. I don't know. I feel like you might miss one. You rush. I can't read that. I want to say it starts with an O though. Oh, there is someone back there. Oh, boy. Snakes, tarantulas, that's what I picture. I'm out here in the middle of nowhere by myself. If I get tagged by something, looks like the YouTube channel's over. Okay, here we go. Who we got? Why are you so hidden? Gabriel Wichester, Witchers. Ooh, born in 1834. Very much hidden. Not visited for a while, I imagine. Okay. I don't see anybody here, but I'm sure there's someone in there. Do you like the sound of blackberries tearing into my pants, my flesh? Because that one hurt. That one really hurt. I'm already bleeding right now. All right. Vandalism on there, yeah. I did read some vandalism happened up here. Unfortunately, it's a hot spot for these style cemeteries that are out in the middle of nowhere. Here we go. Infant son of Clifton and Dora Hill. I'm guessing this is the parents somewhere over here. Bring a friend if you come here. I don't think it's dangerous or anything. I think, I don't know, it's just nice to have a friend with you. Don't be an idiot YouTuber like me. Come alone. I guess we could walk through here. Oh boy. Imagine this is a whole plot here of something, someone. Oh, here we go. Lloyd Yoakum. Notice the spelling too, C-O-M, and then you come over to, I'm guessing, his wife, and she spelled it Y-O-C-U-M. She didn't like the original spelling, I don't know. Not sure what the original spelling is. But I believe the original headstones are still here. So I think in our travels we've seen that usually there's just a headstone with like initials, like JRT. It's all a name, since everyone was kind of, whoa. Yeah, that one looks creepy. Okay. I think for the first time in my life, I'm kind of getting, I don't know, the eerie feeling. Okay, let's go. I never really had that. Okay.
Here is Grace Alice. Oh man, she's only 11 when she died. Somebody visited her at one time. I wonder if somebody else is here. Who might this be?
F.E. Pelter. Young too. Dang. Don't think. Anyone else? These two young individuals. I wonder what the story is behind that. Kind of hidden there. That one. I didn't care for that one for something. That was weird. Okay. I guess once in a while you just get a weird feeling. Here's Yoakum. We talked about Thomas. Oh, and there's the knight symbol. F.C. I think friendship, charity, benevolence. There's someone over there as well. I don't know if you can see that little headstone, but it's hidden. Very, very weathered. We'll work our way into the middle. There's our Civil War buddy we talked about. Mary, read on that one. There's a pretty fantastic memorial in the center. I can't. Jenny? Maybe? Who has? Probably the tallest headstone and the coolest in the whole cemetery. I don't know if we weaved into here. Latham. Now there's a Latham Road that you take to get here. Clearly that's named after them. Another Latham. So this must be the Latham spot here. I think. Underneath a pretty tree. There's a little birdhouse there. There's the hidden Spanish-American War veteran. Maybe a little challenge to find. I see that last name quite a bit here. A lot of there's some writing on this one, huh? Well, actually, I think that headstone maybe is either wore out or maybe it needs flipped up. I'm not sure. Sorry again if this is taking a while. It's kind of a free-for-all when it comes to locations. of the headstones. Like, it should be easier because it is kind of well set up, but at the same time, it's just so much overgrowth, so you don't know what you're gonna run into.
I think that's a wade. It's a wade for a bit.
Yeah. Head over here. I don't know. Some up ahead. That's some Yoakum. Looks like somebody visited. Perhaps long ago. Path over here. I wonder if anything's back here. I guess we'll just go. Maybe it's storage sometimes. Nope. Oh, glad to check. Kind of popped out. Let's get set up here. Sergeant. I feel like we've seen that last thing before. Somewhere. Henry Sergeant. Say 9 years old. I can't see from my viewpoint. Anyways, I hope you guys enjoyed this one. This one was pretty cool. Had a lot of history. It's a little depressing. I don't think anyone's been here for quite some time. Except us now. Challenge you get to, but I'd say worth it. I had sort of like second thoughts as I pulled into the farmland road. I was like, oh boy. But worked out. Hopefully we can get out safe. Pretty, huh? Very quiet as well. But I hope you enjoyed this one, guys. This was, I'd say the new poster child for this channel. Very, our main course style. I make things up on the spot. But I hope you enjoyed the Yoakum family history, the stories, and a little bit of symbolism too, and some neat finds. If you have any other recommendations for cemeteries to visit in Oregon or in Southern Washington, feel free to pipe up below. Hope you're doing good, and stay safe out there. Show you the where you enter from the road, and your only indication of the cemetery is those signs up there, which look rather old. And to get there, and this is why I said, get a truck, gotta travel all the way up there, and Yoakum Cemetery is somewhere over there, hidden among those trees. But yeah, just wanted to show you the trip to get here. A little bit of a rough one, but a fun one.